So Paul knew that, watch. I come around and I taught all of the truth, the real deal. I didn't hide nothing from nobody. I brought it out as it is, as it says in the scripture. So the men and them who in Great Millstone or who teaching the doctrine that Great Millstone teaches, hey, you had to thank the Most High, right? Thank him every minute of the day as you could. Because why? It ain't no joke. Trust me, the Most High ain't no respecter of persons. The Most High ain't no respecter of persons. He don't respect nobody, but it's what he say and it's what he say. That is just it. You understand? That is just it. 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 1. And it says, but there were false prophets among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privily shall bring in damnable heresies, and that is these phony Israelite groups. Like, as I say, the men and them who ain't preaching the truth the correct way, and don't know the self. Even denying the Lord that bought them, Nathaniel 7 openly denied the Lord that bought them. Matter of fact, I'm going to get this precept here real quick. He does openly deny the Lord who bought them, which is Yahawashi and not Christ. Yahawashi. You understand? Not Christ. This is Exodus, the law. Exodus 20. Verse 7, it says, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy power, Yahawah, thy power, in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. And that is who? That is men who teaching you about Christ, and men who ain't coming around teaching you the real doctrine. So Nate, you're not guiltless in the eyesight of the Most High. And I hope you see this video. And men who deny the Lord's name, Yahawashi, you ain't guiltless in the eyesight of the Most High. So it says, even denying the Lord that bought them and bring upon themselves swift destruction. You understand? And that is these false prophets. So, through a process of elimination, we know who the false prophets are. The men and them who really know don't know the truth. We know the false prophets is like men like the HODC, the IUIC, the leaders of them camps, the GOCC, yeah, the name these guys have, Israel United in Christ. Christ, Israel never was united. The times when Israel was united, under the time of Solomon, which was the Most High son, Yahawashi, as Solomon, we were united under the name of Yahawah. When we was taken out of Egypt, we were united under the name of Yahawah. David, King David, had the whole 12 tribes under him, united under the name of Yahawah. We were never united under Christ. So Israel ain't going to ever unite in Christ. So that just that alone, the Most High is going to destroy that organization. Then GOCC, gathering of Christ Church. And you preach in Israel? No, the Most High, Christ never had a church. Yahawashi had a church. Christ never had a church. You understand? Who is that again? Zabak, AOI. He preached Yahawashi, but he believed the mark of the beast is philosophy in your mind. He misleading you. He ain't going the right way and bring the truth to you. And he believe Cornelius is a damn Edomite. How the hell? You want Cornelius to be an Edomite? Come on. Come on. Scriptures clearly say he's an Israelite. Clearly it says he's an Israelite. These Psalms 127, verse 1. It says, except Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi keep the city, the watchman walk it, wake it, but in vain. So, what is the house? The Most High looking, the Most High trying, he establishing the house of David, which begins with the 144,000 men. Men who was back there with King David. You understand? Because it says that in Amos 9 that he will raise up the tabernacle of David as it was in the days of old. You understand? So that the house he looking to build, and that begins with the apostle elders, a great millstone. And the brothers who in this truth, who under that same banner, under that same order, the same teachings, how the apostle elders, a great millstone, does teach it and sincerely believe, you hopefully might build up that house at David. The elect build up the body of Yahawashi. You understand? So it says, except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that buildeth it. And who labor in vain? These false teachers out here, because they're trying to build a house, but they're trying to build a house on this side, and they're trying to build a house not under Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi, but Christ and God and Jesus and all these false and fake God. So we who know we had the truth through the apostles, through the spirit of Yahawah by Yahawashi, we had to be thankful for that. Every day we had to thank the Most High for that. Every day, thank Him. Thank Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi for that. You understand? I have an next precept here. It's Isaiah 30 and 20. Now this could go on whole day. So, but I'm going to take whole day. This is Isaiah 30 and 20. And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the waters of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see thy teachers. And that, hey, through the unicorn, through the men and them being out on the highways and the byways, that proves that you had to go out on the streets. You understand? Don't mind that you see brothers doing sit downs, because right now I'm sitting down in my house, in my apartment here, and doing a video, but I just go outside here and blaze, or go outside here on the streets and preach. You understand? And all brothers in we camp just do that. That is how your eyes go see your teachers. Because they're going to be outside there. Or they're going to be constantly putting up videos on the YouTube to show that to show the diligence. And the teachers, you're going to notice them. You understand? I'll just read the verse, verse 21. It says, and thine ear shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, when ye turn to the right hand and when ye turn to the left. And that's what is going on when you are now coming into the truth. So we had to really be thankful that the Most High, Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi, opened up the eyes, but He opened our eyes to see what is the real deal of the whole matter, because that false prophet out there who deliberately sold out and who go and get your debt. Yeah. To go in and get your debt. You go die. You keep following them fellas, your debt. And you know Jake's scared to die. Jake is one people who afraid death. So then, if it's so, it had to have a power, Yahawah by Hashem Yahawashi, and he must set up men to bring the real deal. So then it had to have somebody who had the truth. And brothers know, hold on. Yeah, and brothers know that the elders are great millstones, the men. You understand? That he demanded on them who was with the Lord. Back then, I have some precepts written down here. I have about 3 more. But I feel like I read the whole 3 and shorten it. This is Matthew 24:24. It says, is the Lord given warning and what going to come to the elect? Matthew 24:24. For there shall arise false anointed. That is these men and them who say, We are the Lord. We anointed by the Most High to teach the truth. And false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, in so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. So it's impossible to deceive the elect. It's not possible. So the so-called white man using all his tactics to try and buy out. To try and buy out all these Israelite groups and pay them off to teach the wrong thing. All you deceiving is the ones who the Most High wanted to deceive anyhow. That is all you're doing. You ain't deceiving the elect. You're deceiving because scripture says it's not possible to deceive the elect. You understand? It's not possible to deceive the elect. To the ones on them who in darkness, they're going to always be in darkness. You understand? This is Isaiah 60 verse 1. It says, arise and shine, and that is what the elect will do. For thy light is come, Jesus' knowledge. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. You understand? So, hey, we the elect get the glory of the Most High, and the shine and the light come. Yahawashi is the light, and I always say he come in the volume of the book, which is the comforter, which is the truth, which is what he died and unloosed the 7 seals thereof. Is this book? This is the book. The lion of the tribe of Judah, Yahawashi, says, arise and shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. But that begins with the elect. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord, Yahawah, shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. Understand? And I have one more precept in the pack. As Apostle the letter had us jokingly say, and them men and them that's, hey, I don't know. They don't try to be funny, but they're funny. When you watch it, they're making it exciting to learn. They had this big Israelite summit the other day, Hebrew summit in New York, and there's a bunch of dead. Like, all of them just lifeless, but they ain't preaching, they ain't teaching shit. These Sirach 2051 and 22, in the Apocrypha, it says, the Lord hath given me a tongue for my reward, and I will praise him therewith. Draw near unto me, ye unlearned, and dwell in the house of learning. Beginning with the apostles, a great millstone. And the men and them who come in, who sincerely believe, they drew near unto the Most High and dwell in the house of learning. Where we learn? Where you learn that the mark of the beast is the RFID microchip? The apostles are great millstone. Where you learn that Cornelius is an Israelite? And Nathan all learned that from the apostles are great millstone. General Yohanan, all these guys who just teach that Cornelius is Israelite now, learn that from the apostles, a great millstone. So the brothers who in this, and under that banner, GMS, or not even if you know under the banner, great, if you don't have the name great millstone, but you're teaching how they does teach, you are dwelling in the house of learning. It says, wherefore are ye slow? So, hey, you had to say thank Tawara Yahawah Ba'asham Yahawashi for that. It says, wherefore are ye slow? And what say ye to these things, seeing your souls are very thirsty? That is these guys and them who sluggish. Why we got murmur against these things, seeing your souls very thirsty? Near thirsty, General Yahana thirsty, all these false Israelite groups are thirsty. And the slow to go to the apostles and ask for water in sincerity and in truth, because they have the rivers of living water. Says he that believeth on me, out of his belly shall flow what? Rivers of living water. Could clearly see the apostles are that, and the brothers who under them, who in good standing. It says, I opened my mouth and said, buy her for yourselves without money. You understand? That is the truth. Buy her for yourselves without money. Buy her for, oh yeah, just buy she without money. You devote your time and your effort and your study, you show diligence, you're buying she. But you ain't go and pay, you ain't digging in your pocket and say, here, look, I want this. No, you can't get that. But you show diligence. And that way, just buy her without money. Put your neck under the yoke, meaning what? Chain down yourself to she, and let your soul receive instruction. She is hard at hand to find. That is the wisdom, knowledge, understanding. It's hard at hand to find. But to the elect, it will be easy to find. But to the two-thirds, it will be hard to find. But to the elect, it will be easy. You understand? And with that, I will close. Hey, the brothers in this truth, boy, in this, under the banner of Great Millstone, who teach the same truth that Great Millstone preach, thank the Most High, boy. Thank Yahawah Ba'asham Yahawashi that he didn't send you to these other Israelite groups, because you'd have been bugged out your fucking mind. I can tell you that much. Because Nate sold out. Nathaniel 7 sold out. He did sell out. Whether you know it or not, he did. He did take money. He did to pervert the gospel. So hey, to that I would say Barakatai Yahawah Ba'asham Yahawashi and Tawara and double honors to the apostle elders of Great Millstone, man. That's real well. Salutations to the Ahchyam around the world who sincerely believe in this truth and pushing it in sincerity. Till the next time, say Shalom.